I'd just like to say for the record that you don't know what you're talking about, so it's okay. Are we going to start the show?
With that introduction, yes.
With that sort of introduction, I think that's the sort of thing we should do.
Words, you're making up yet introduction.
Introduction. I like the extra syllables because it makes me sound more important.
Okay.
Yes. Do you sound more important when you use more syllables in words?
No.
Necessary?
No, I just pull facial expressions. It makes me feel better.
That makes you feel better?
Yeah, it does.
How about the people around you? Do they feel better?
You can say cat and go cat, and then cat, and then cat.
Yeah.
It doesn't mean anything. It all depends on the vases you pull.
This doesn't work on radio.
No, but, you know, it's just imagine. Pulling different faces while you say different things.
Oh, say different things. Okay, so say the word cat three times.
Cat.
With different faces. Yep. No. Imagine that.
Cat.
Imagine that.
Cat.
Oh, you're a crazy
The last
person.
One was a biggie.
I didn't like it, actually.
Neither did I. I can't be fucked.
Oh, well. This is what we do. This is our radio thing. Oh, I'm on the radio now. Listen to me talking.
It's the internet, not the radio.
It's the radio.
Tune in to www.onyourwireless.
I'm listening to the shortwave radio session. When you were a kid, did you ever have one of those radios that did, you know, you've got the AM and FM broadband? They didn't have broadband. Just bands, they were called back in the day. AM and FM bands. Mm-hmm. But on the older radios, they had shortwave 1 and shortwave 2 as well.
No.
Did you ever have a radio like that?
If it existed, I was too young to really care about it.
Oh, so what? You're saying I'm old?
No, I mean, it was more to do with, like, I did have the shortwave thing, but it was Mum and Dad bought me a little kit, which was like a shortwave radio, and you talk to your friends or, you know, other people and stuff like that. But I was the only person I knew that had it. So the only people I could speak to were truckers.
Yeah.
I was about 6 years old listening to old men swear, and then they would get the shits with me. And then one day, I loved it. I loved talking to these people as a little kid. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And one day, Mum came out into the garden, and she heard me laughing, and then this, like, distorted, like, through a horrible old cheap speaker, this trucker telling me to go F myself and everything. And, yeah, she took it away.
Fair enough. Yeah. Well, caring parents, they need to look after their kids.
Exactly. Here you go, talk to some old angry, drunk, fat, sweaty men who drive trucks all day. This is the best present ever. I like Count Duckula.
What?
Get the fuck off the shortwave, mate. I like Count Duckula.
But what I was saying about the shortwave radio thing is, like, yeah, back in the day, as I explained, FM, AM, those are normal bands, and some of the older radios had SW1 and SW2, and that was shortwave frequencies.
Yeah.
And I don't know exactly what they were for, but I used to think they were for, you know, secret codes from spies and stuff, because every now and again, if you'd, like, you'd go through, you'd scroll along, and you'd pick up weird, you know, electrical noises, currents and pulses and things from things. And I used to sit there for hours going, like, scrolling along going, what's this? What's this? Scanning into it. And then there'd be a bit of a beep, 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 beep. Like something like that. And I'd be like, secret code. It's a secret
code. I never got that, but I did do that thing. You know when you had the old TVs where you had to UHF? It would tune into a radio station. And I always think, because it was always like, you'd look at the screen, there'd be distortion, there'd be snow, but you could hear stuff going on. And always think, I found the secret TV station. I'm tuning into Russia, whatever.
Russia radio.
I thought it was a TV station, but nobody knew about it. It was just this thing. But yeah, it was just the radio.
Yeah.
I didn't know that when I was little.
Didn't know that.
Mum and Dad come in. What are you doing? Turn it back on the normal thing. Stop fiddling with the knobs.
You've ruined Christmas. Again.
Christmas. Yeah. That was on one of the topics that you want to talk about.
Christmas is a topic. And it's also an occasion, which has just happened, because today is the 28th.
It is.
A couple of days after.
Because my fine was due on the 27th, so it was that's how I live my life with dates. This one's due here, this one's due there, I'm 5 days away.
No, that's fair enough, Christmas, it's one of those things that has plagued my life since I was born.
Yep.
It was nice when I was a kid, when it was the Santa Claus thing, and, you know, you'd get your presents and that sort of... Did your mum and dad ever do Santa Claus, or did they just go, no?
They did for a bit. Mm. I don't remember the point where they said Santa Claus doesn't exist. But I think I just grew out of it of my own volition. But they did when I was younger.
They did Santa Claus?
Okay. I had to leave the milk and the cookie and It was, the glass of water and the barbecue shape out.
I was going to say, I mean, you're going to leave milk and a cookie out, and you know, you're under, what do you call it, minimum wage family household. You just wasted a glass of milk. You know, you just left it out there all night.
Yeah, I will say, well,
the dog might drink
obviously
it.
It's the parents who would drink it, but they'd probably share it, the two shots.
You think that?
And they'd crush up the barbecue shape and do lines of it. Such is the working class life. But we did do Santa Claus.
Were there ever like notes left, like from Santa saying, "Dear, you know, boys, I came and ate the cookie and it was good."
No, it was never. It was never a big deal. Like, I'd watch it on TV and as a kid, and mum and dad would recognize it by going, "All right, Santa Claus is coming. Whatever, you should leave the thing out. Just go to bed." Actually, I remember when I realized that Santa Claus didn't exist, because I got told to go to bed, and then I went to bed, and then when I heard them going, mum and dad went into the bedroom, I ran out and I crawled under the couch, because it was there was enough space for me to go there, and I camped out there for ages and ages and ages and ages, and then the light came on, and I was peeking out, I could see mum and dad bringing presents and sticking them under the tree, and then dad drinking the milk and eating, biscuit or bread, I don't know what the hell it was, but he basically...
I hope he knew what it was before he had it.
He devoured what it was. And then, that was the point where I realised, oh my God, it's them that are doing it. Yeah.
Oh dear. I don't recall actually having a, you know, doing the Santa Claus thing, but I don't understand why parents will do this to their kids. I mean, just go, look, it's a day where, you know, we appreciate that we are privileged. It's in my ideal world, Christmas would be Thanksgiving.
Thanks for sticking around.
Yeah, we don't have a Thanksgiving in Australia. Perhaps we should, and we should make it Christmas Day. Take away the Santa Claus, take away the Jesus, because none of it's really relevant. Just like hang out with your family if you like them. If you don't like them, don't, because seriously, like, you're just going to have a really bad time.
Well, see, it's a funny thing, isn't it? Like, you don't need to add all this idiot sort of stuff like, well, what happens on Christmas? Let me tell you, young Jimmy, there's a giant invisible squid that lives in the clouds, and he comes down, and his tentacles touch you when you're sleeping, and if you've got the right acidic levels on your skin, he'll give you a present, but if you've got the wrong acidic levels, you get a bag of shit. And that's it. And that's Christmas. Happy Christmas. Look after acidic levels. Like, it's just a weird concept.
Why do we have to have days for things? Can't we just, like, you know, exist in a sort of, like, a void of wandering around?
What are you talking about? We're either getting on to free will, where we're not obligated, we can do what we want when we want. Or some abstract thing that I'm not quite understanding.
I'm not exactly sure I understand what I'm talking about either, but I've taken us out here on this journey, and we're out here in the void, and there's no Christmas, and there's no Mother's Day, but there is St. Patrick's Day, because... we've got nothing.
Well, what was one of the most memorable Christmases that you ever had? Like, something that sticks out in your head really badly.
Look, it was actually a really bad time. The most memorable Christmas I ever had. It was a good Christmas. Like, a lot of the Christmases were, because it was family coming together. You get to see cousins and hang out and play. And, you know, you get some cool presents and stuff. That typical, you know, Western thing. And the barbecue and the dinner and all that. And you're like, yeah, cool. And running around like an idiot with all your other... you know, similar aged cousins at some person's house that you've never been before, and riding other people's bikes and that sort of thing. And because...
these family members family down the road?
Well, speaking of the family down the road, we did throw rocks at them, and then we got in trouble. I don't know. Oh, I know exactly how we got in trouble, actually. They told on us, and then they came over. Okay, that makes sense. I thought for a moment there. Anyway, the rock throwing incident, that is not part of this particular story, even though I think it was on the same day. Riding a bike that is not your own, it takes a bit of getting used to. Like, you get on a bike, and, you know, it's true that when you ride a bike, you never forget
How to swim. Yep.
Yeah, I remember. You never forget how to swim.
Especially when it's someone else's bike. It's probably five times too big for you.
But yeah, it's either too big or too small. Crankshafts are a bit weird. Seats in the wrong place. Yep. You know.
I'm imagining you dressed as Goldilocks riding different sized bikes right now.
And I probably was at this stage. But anyway, yeah, riding my cousin's bike and doing all of these amazing tricks and things on the bike as you would on Christmas Day, going, yes, this is the best Christmas in the world. And the thing about the place where I was at, it was in a cul-de-sac. And a cul-de-sac is not a thing that I'd spent a Christmas in before.
Yep.
For those that don't know, a cul-de-sac is a street that ends. Like, it's a dead end, basically. And typically around the gutter area. Like, your typical gutter... Now, here's some interesting
story. This is sounding so depressing. I lived in a dead end. I had to ride other people's bikes. I threw rocks at people. There was gravel everywhere. Like, it stood out of all the Christmases.
Like I said, it was a great... Look, it was a great Christmas. Okay. And shut up, because I'm going to get back to the gutters.
All right, yep. I was living in the gutter. I had a chip packet stuck to the side of my face.
The street gutter. Your typical street gutter is square. And if you're riding a bicycle, you can't easily ride up a gutter without doing a bit of a bunny hop action.
Yeah.
You know what I'm
talking
about?
Or a mono. And,
or popping a mono, as the kids might say. What?
That's like a euphemism, but...
That's a euphemism?
Mm.
Nah.
Anyway, so square gutter, you're riding...
Square gutter, riding along. And no, there wasn't a square gutter. That's the point. A cul-de-sac has a kind of like 45-degree angle gutter.
Yeah, it's curved.
It's
curved.
Yeah,
so you can kind of ride up without having to do magic...
And, you know, when you're a kid, you know, riding a skateboard and that sort of thing, you always dream of, like, you know, sort of curved gutters and things so you can go, and do tricks and ride up sideways and things like you do in cartoons and that sort of thing.
Yeah.
So I'm riding around with my bike going, I can ride sideways along this gutter. And I'm riding along the gutter and it had rained about 2 hours previously, so it was a bit wet. And I'm riding along and I'm like, this is the best thing in the world. Fact is, I've never done this before and therefore it was going to end in disaster. And it did. Like, I cannot tell you the exact moment, but there was definitely an issue in tire to gutter. What's that word when
ratio.
Things stick together? I don't know, friction?
Okay.
Like, there was a friction issue.
What? Because it was raining.
It wasn't raining. It had rained.
So it was wet.
It was still wet,
so
yeah.
The gutter's concrete on a curve.
Yeah.
You're on the bike, rubber tires.
Oh, maybe it wasn't because it was raining. It was probably because I was shit.
I'm just trying to work out. So anyway, what happened?
Fell off and I put a really big hole in my knee. I've got a scar to this day on my knee. And this is like the most memorable Christmas in the world because of this fucking...
You're reminded every day out of the
every
shower
day.
In the front of the mirror.
Yeah, so every,
fucking
you know...
Christmas.
Every, you know, silly season, you know, they start putting the ads up and you go to the mall and it's all like, la, 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 happy, happy time. And you're like, ah, my knee hurts.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's why I don't like Christmas.
See, I think it's more about the experience. And this is that thing I've told you about before. When I was young, I think I was maybe about 9 or 10, something like that, when Game Boys were sort of, you know, out and they were the big thing and whatnot.
Yeah.
And I was like on my mum and dad's back. I'm like, can I please, Game Boy, I'll give you the hint about what I want for Christmas. Please buy me a Game Boy. There's your hint. And they sort of said, leave it with us. Dad, mum was sort of like, look, we'll see. Dad was more like, we'll see. Like hinting as if you're definitely going to get one. We'll see. So I assumed I was going to get one.
Yeah.
Came to Christmas Day, came outside, and there's this huge box under the Christmas tree, all wrapped up, like huge, like bigger than me. I'm like, I don't care about the gumbo. What the hell's in the box? Tore all the wrapping off. It was a cardboard box. Like, okay. All right, it's probably inside there. Okay, so I open the cardboard box. What's inside? Polystyrofoam packing. That's it. So I'm looking at Mum and Dad. Oh, okay, yep. Thanks for the box of polystyrofoam. Dad's like, no. Dig into it. Find something. All right. Dig in. And I pull this thing out, and it's a present wrapped up.